This is going to be one of the biggest years of my life, but I'm here for it. I've prepared the best that I possibly can to put myself in the best position this year. Trust me when I say this, the time is now.
What's up, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of The Time Is Now. I thought it would be very important here to kind of go through my second push session of the week. Those of you guys who have already watched the first push session, or maybe the first pull session, maybe the first leg session, we like to do walkthroughs explaining exactly what we're doing, why we're doing it, and the thoughts and the methods behind the choices that we make. So we're going to come in today with our second session. I think the first point I want to talk about today is that it is important to have more than one session. If you have the same session every single week, you're fighting an uphill battle. You're going to run out of room to progress. You're going to find little niggles start to creep in, and you're going to find that accumulation of fatigue is very, very quick. So we're on our second session. We're going to start off here with cuffed clavicular flies. We're very much trying to target that upper portion of the pec, the sternoclavicular joint right across into the shoulder. We're trying to bias this upper half of the pec before we get into the meat of it later on. So two sets here, 1 6 to 10, 1 10 to 12. Trying to bias that thing that we want to grow most with a priority principle of doing it first with the most energy, clavicular flies. So we use this exercise as a one, because we are trying to break down that muscle. We are trying to grow the upper chest, but also it works really well as a priming exercise, because we now got a little bit of blood in the chest. It's a little bit safer through the joints now. We had these on right at the start above the elbow, so it massively reduces any joint pressure in your shoulder and also the elbow. So you're not going from like a cold start straight into it. You know, you're not just jumping the car straight in. We're warming up, we're getting things moving. Before we load up nicely. All right, we're in. For those of you guys who saw the Instagram post, 75 kilo dumbbell press, low incline. There we go. Go! Oh. Real quick, tried to go a little bit lower than last time. 5 reps. So we've primed ourselves nicely on those cuffed clavicular flies. A big incline load. Now we're gonna hit the meat of the pec with just a flat press. This is the hammer strength press. If you guys have this, you'll note that sometimes it's quite hard to get yourself under it. All we're gonna do here is just put two plates here, which is just gonna rise you a little bit here, put you into an active range of motion, ready for the exercise. Ooh. Fuck. I am feeding prep today, apparently, because a few little regressions here and there. It's getting heavy, but it's to be expected. I'm 7.5 kilos down. We've just got to take what we can. Fuck. Okay. Ha. Ah.
fuck, I've got nothing left.
That's where you insert, you know, Ian Beale.
I've got nothing left.
I have to reassess this for next session because I've been hammered today. But you win some, you lose some. As long as the outcome is income. Fucking hell. Can't even move that way. Ooh. So lying lateral cuff raises here, feeling heavy like the rest of the fucking session, but managed to get a PB. I think isolation's a lot easier to move forward than a big press, especially when you're losing weight, so we're just going to focus on progressing what we can here, and the ones we can't take, we don't take them. It's not the day, but we'll rest up, feed up, and see if we can come back another time. Three sets on here, 8 to 12 reps on each, just to smash the delts, and then we've got a little bit of arms and done. Arms now. So we're going to use a bench here for support, so we can lean against it, really arch into it. We're going to cross over these, and we're going to basically just do a normal tricep extension like you would. But we've got a little bit more of a fixed environment, keep it safer, but keep it more accurate as well. Training arms on this day versus the other day, something to note. This is a lot more higher reps. This is a lot higher reps than all that English was then. Focus more on just blood and muscle rather than I'm still trying to progress, I'm still trying to do more, but I'm much more focused on just firing blood into the arms, trying to get a big pump and getting in and out quicker, because we have biceps on pull day, we have triceps on push day, we have both arms on this day. You will start to accumulate that fatigue a little bit, so just don't go full speed and just chase a pump on this day. We're gonna wrap this up. It's been another good push session. Like I said, this one definitely took a hit. I've been having the odd session like that. It's important to know that as part of a dieting phase, you're gonna have those times when you're a little bit flat. You're doing cardio every day, and then you're trying to progress fucking 75 kilo dumbbells. Like it's not always gonna happen. So my best advice is to take the smallest increment you can down and try and maintain it. If you can get a volume PR rather than a strength PR, you're still gonna have that progression. So you take 75 kilos by 6 reps, you know, plus 60 kilos times 9 reps, you've got a total volume there. So if I fail that 75 kilos and only get 5 reps, I know that if I do 1 or 2 more reps on that 60, I've accumulated more volume, which is what I try and do, where the where the strength goes, but you've also got to find that fine line of chasing numbers, chasing strength retention, but that digs a deficit, a fatigue deficit. And the harder you push, the more volume you want to do. Maybe you fail those 75s and you want to do a drop set to make up for it. Well, that drop set's going to eat into your recovery and eat into your fatigue. So you've got to play this game in your head when you're making these decisions to either come down or progress, that actually sometimes just throwing the kitchen sink at it isn't the best idea, because you're going to have that delayed onset of fatigue, and it's going to eat into your further sessions, you know. So it's a very good session. I want to say thank you to Physique Warehouse. This is, you guys who follow the channel for a while, one of my favorite gyms in the UK, some of the best lighting in the UK, and they've just had the whole place refurbed and then it got closed down. So if any of you guys are in the Sunbury, Walton on Thames area within half an hour, 45 minutes of this gym, even an hour, I drove an hour to get here today. I highly recommend you coming to get to this gym when the gyms open up. So thank you to the guys at Physique Warehouse. Amazing facility. I love this gym. I'll definitely be back when it's open again, and we'll speak to you guys soon. I hope you guys are enjoying the series. We'll be back soon, guys. Peace and love. Bye-bye.